gentlemen, welcome to another fresh episode of our program, which is brought to you from the radio, from the television service of Borno State University Television. I am your one and favorite uncle. My name is Ahmed Medibu. As you all know, our program has 5 different segments. For the news, we have Mary Animu.
Monday Market has always been a bustling center of commerce, but an unfortunate fire incident has caused many traders struggling to rebuild their businesses. It is in February that the fire outbreak completely burned the entire market and took more than 7 hours before the fire service respondent arrived. More traders lost their businesses that are the source of livelihood. In the following days, the governor of Borno State, Professor Babagana Umar Ezulum, along with the general manager of Monday Market, Barrister Mustafa Loskarima, met with traders and shop owners to get compensation and rebuild the market. Mr. Collins and Madam Ibrahim are traders who have been selling stuff in the Monday market for 15 to 20 years, described the situation as mysterious and could not understand how the fire started and consumed the entire market in a very short time. The market was reopened in October by the governor of Borno State with a support of 800 million naira to about 2,800 traders. The governor also lifted payments of rent for the next 2 years. The model market structured involved a comprehensive redesign and an expansion plan with a more organized and accessible space for business activities. Borno State University had, on Tuesday, 5th December marked the end of 2022-2023 academic session and a historic moment for producing its first set of students. The pioneer of students marched throughout the campus celebrating the moments in their colorful dress. The students of the university, along with other principal officers and departmental staff, enjoined the students in celebrating the moment.
Graduating students of Borno State University expressed great joy that the journey of 4 years had come to an end. The students thanked the university lecturers and management for their efforts to accommodate and impart knowledge in them, as well as good morals and hard work. The graduation of the pioneer set of the university was made possible after the resource verification team from the National Universities Commission, NUC, last year granted final approval to the school to fully conduct all sorts of teaching and practice in its 32 degree programs in 5 faculties and graduate the students as BSc and BEd holders. The Vice Chancellor, Professor Umar Kyari Sandabe, congratulated and rejoiced with the students and urged them to be good ambassadors of the university by implementing the good things they have learned at the school and expand their search for knowledge, on whose the motto stands as knowledge has no boundary. Yusuf Sani reporting.
In the ever increasing Gamboru market of Maiduguri, the blacksmiths are using their creative skills in creating useful tools. The chairman, Borno State Blacksmith Business, Malam Babagana Usman, told our newsmen during their visit to the market. The report.
Gamboru Market is located at the heart of Maiduguri, the capital city of Borno State. The market is popular with the ironsmith work, where useful tools such as knife, pot, axe, hoe, plate, and other hand tools are produced. The chairman said that the tools made here are transported to several towns for the commercial purpose. Ibrahim Muhammad is an ironsmith that specializes in making knives and other tools. He explained that they make different varieties of kitchen wares. Ahmad Abdullahi, also a young man that makes forks and other garden tools, said he spent more than a decade in the trade. He further said the challenge they face in the job is the shortage of raw materials due to ban of ajakota business in Maiduguri by the state government. He is therefore pleading to the Borno State government and other policy makers to look up the matter against the betterment of its people. Abdusalam Muhammad reporting.
The proprietors of informal Quranic learning center, popularly known as Sangaya in Maiduguri, have called on the government and relevant activities to intervene on the sector to address the problem challenging the sustainability of informal Quranic education in the state.
Madam Awal Abdullahi, a preparator of Wansangaya School and a teacher, said that such an education is historically important and called for the need of recognition at the tertiary levels of education. Malam Abdullahi also said that the Borno State government had not chosen his school in its ongoing post-literacy program by the World Bank titled Better Education Service Delivery for All, BESDA, that has helped some Sangaya schools in Maiduguri. In another encounter with Malam Muhammad Umar, assistant proprietor of Malam Bashir Sangaya School, said for more than a decade, their school had not gotten any support from the government. He added that his students do not get 3 square meals a day due to the economic situation. Malam Muhammad Umar called on the parents and guardians who are willing to take their children to Sangaya schools to take full responsibilities for better teaching and learning. Mustafa Abdullahi reporting.
University of Maiduguri graduates over 3,000 undergraduate students, confers doctorate degrees and professors emeritus, along with honorary degrees. The 24th combined convocation of the university, held at Muhammadu Indini International Conference Center on 18th November 2023, was graced by prominent individuals throughout Nigeria, where 3 professors emeritus and PhDs were conferred academic and deserving individuals.
The convocation ceremony is an occasion organized by the university to award certificate to deserving graduates of 2017-2018, 2018-2019, 2019-2020, and 2020-2021 academic session. The university has successfully graduated over 33,000 undergraduate students, awarded doctorate degrees, and conferred professor emeritus on 3 of its lecturers. The vice chancellor, Professor Aliu Shugaba, has explained that the first insurgence era and normalization of activities in Maiduguri had resulted in rapid increase of admitting more students into university, given the statistical number of graduates of 24th combined convocation ceremony. Also at the convocation ceremony, the university has inaugurated its chancellor, retired Justice Sidi Baje Muhammad Dipes, CFR, who is the emir of Lafia Barebari, and has awarded 3 professor emeritus to Professor Abubakar Mustafa of Sharia Department, Professor Bamidele Rotimi Badejo of Language and Linguistics, and Professor Muhammad Yerima Balla of Mathematical Science Department. The chancellor also conferred honorary doctorate degrees to 4 of prominent personality, which include the Vice President, Senator Dr. Kashim Shatima, the Sheikh of Borno, Alhaji Dr. Abubakar Umar Ibn Garbe Al-Amin El-Kelemi, the Chief Executive Officer, Bua Group, Alhaji Dr. Abdussamad Isia Karabiu, as well as the former registrar with the university, Alhaji Dr. Dahiru Boko. The Chancellor of the University, His Eminence Justice Sidi Baje, expressed his utmost gratitude for the remarkable recognitions on the awarding personalities for their tireless scholarly contribution, dedication, sacrifice for the development of the university and Nigeria as a whole. The combined convocation ceremony witnessed the attendance of visitors to the university, President Bola Ahmed Tinubu, ably represented by the Vice President, where he commissioned Abdussamad Rabiu International Center for Innovation and Entrepreneurship, project worth over 2 billion naira, donated by the Chairman Bua Group, Dr. Abdussamad Isiaka Rabiu, to the university. Amongst the attendees include the Secretary to the Government of Federation, Minister of Agriculture, Minister of Solid and Mineral Resources, Governors of Borno, Nasarawa, Yobe, and Jigawa State, as well as the emirs, kings, state and federal stakeholders, parents, guardians, students, and lovers to the university. Tijani Bulama reporting.
We have the first gospel.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
What is your name?
My name is Hassan Abubakar.
From which department?
From the Department of Political Science.
If your GPU converted 80 million, what type of car will it buy?
Beetle.
Beetle?
Yeah.
How much is Beetle now?
I think it's not much, but I don't know the price.
But you assume your GPU will buy it?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, how are you?
What is your name?
My name is Abdul Karim Omar Bulde from University of Maiduguri, studying pure and applied chemistry.
Assume your GP converted into millions, what type of car will it buy?
I buy 4 seats.
Forces?
Yes.
How much is Forces?
800,000.
800,000?
Yes.
Second hand?
No.
The new brand?
Yes.
800?
Yes.
Are you a dealer?
No.
For the discussion program, we have Aisha Kirawa.
Good morning, Maiduguri. It's still me, A.E. Kirawa, your host, and you're welcome to BOSU Campus Talk Show. And today on our show, we'll be discussing on impact of street hawking on young girls, specifically in Maiduguri, Borno State Capital. And with me in the studio is Hajia Fadila Mustafa, who is the principal of Government Girls College, Maiduguri, and also a human rights activist on girls' child education. It's a great pleasure to have you here, ma'am.
Thank you.
And also speaking to us this morning is Commissioner for Higher Education, Barrister Mustafa Muhammad. It's a great pleasure to have you here, sir. And lastly is Hajia Maryam Kamilu, who is a successful businesswoman, a philanthropist who started as a hawker, and now she has sponsored more than 500 girls' child into schools. It's a great pleasure to have you here, ma'am.
Thank you.
So viewers, sit back, relax, and let's go on a short break. How did you get started as a hawker, and what kind of challenges did you face?
Yes, I started as a hawker since at my early age.
Okay.
Because at that time my father was sick, and he needed
medications.
Yes, he needed medication, and he's a jobless.
Okay.
He's suffering from a critical illness.
Okay.
So at that time, my mother decided to start mini business at home.
Okay.
So she started cooking food for me, and take it.
Then you used to take it outside, take to go and sell
outside,
the food.
Yes.
Okay.
I used to take the food outside to go on the streets. I used to go like line by line mall, especially like bus stop, where people are still there. So she started with local food, you know, in our traditional Hausa. We started with garau garau.
Okay.
And moi moi.
So
at that time, so I used to take the food and go around and sell them.
What kind of challenges did you face as a hawker?
Yes, you know, every successful woman or man, person there at all, must face a lot of challenges.
Most especially as a hawker.
More especially as a hawker like me, because I face up challenges like harassment,
okay,
negligence in our family and relatives in the society. During that time, as time goes on, we are selling food, as time goes on, my mother died. At the time that she died, you see, I would be the breadwinner of the family.
Okay.
So I used to take care of my siblings.
Since you are the first
child.
Yes,
and I'm,
sorry.
And I'm the first daughter in our family. I have siblings, so I used to take care of them. And the medication of my father, since I told you earlier, he's sick. He's suffering from critical disease. So I used to take that responsibility. All the responsibilities on me. And when they will provide everything in our family. So I used to
suffer.
Yes, and our family neglect us because they see us as a responsibility. We cannot afford them with anything, unlike
when your mom was alive or
no,
when your dad was healthy
was
enough.
Sick, yes.
The principal, Hajia Fadila, what are the economical challenges facing girls who are involved in street hawking?
Thank you. When you said educational challenges, there are a lot of challenges, not only educational, but now since we are specifying on educational, so I will talk about, I can mention one to two things and explain. First, there is, missing of school. When I say missing of school, these children prioritize money more than going to school because they don't know the benefit of education. Secondly, there is lack of access to resources to pay their school fees.
What kind of resources?
Resources means money.
Okay.
Since they are hawking to get money to make a living, so they have lack of money to pay for the school fees.
Okay.
In some houses, you will see that it's only two to three children that will go to school, but the remaining children, as they are at home, due to lack of that resources. And that resources relating to educational, there will be lack of good uniforms and textbooks. which have negative impact on their academic performance.
Okay, so how can school work with families to reduce this number of street workers in our society?
By creating awareness.
Okay.
When I say creating awareness, I mean with the government now. Mm. It's not only school. The school can call the attention of government, since now I'm a government school principal.
Mm-hmm.
We can say that we have a large population of street hawkers outside there, mm-hmm. rather than being in school.
Okay.
So we can call the attention of government to create a committee that will ban street hawking,
mm-hmm.
and provide more scholarship for these children to be in school, which will encourage them. This will encourage the children to go to school, because the parents know that they are not paying any money for the school. So the children will now start attending classes often and whatever it is necessary for them to do in classes.
Back to our Honorable Commissioner for Higher Education, Barrister Mustafa Muhammad, what do you think is the biggest challenges in implementing policies to help girls who are working as a hawker?
Thank you very much, for having me here.
Mm.
And it's really an honor to sit here today with Haja Mariam Kamilu, who has been a source of inspiration for me growing up and becoming a lawyer that I am today. And I've read so many of your books, Ma, and most especially my favorite, Hard Work Peace. Thank you very much, Ma, for the inspiration. Our government is really doing a lot, putting efforts to see that the girls go to school. In Northern Nigeria, we have this ideology that women are supposed to be housewives,
okay.
and it's a very bad ideology.
Mm.
But not all of the Northerners believe in that.
Mm.
So we are doing everything possible to see that formal education progresses in Northern Nigeria,
mm.
especially Borno State.
Mm.
So we have this group that we created.
Okay.
We send them to local governments.
What kind of group?
Yeah, it's a group of individuals,
okay.
that we sent,
mm.
to local government areas for orientations.
Okay.
You know, most of the major challenge we are having is with the parents.
Mm.
Yeah, because they are not educated, they don't want their girls to go to school.
Mm.
They believe that girls are only meant to be housewives. So these groups that we created make sure that, you know, they enlighten these parents about the importance of education for the girls.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, the government is really trying to see that schools are built for girls. Because, you know, they said that girls, women are weaker vessels. So we have to help them. Yeah, we have to help them a lot.
And there's a word that said if you educate a girl,
the woman
is like you.
You have educated
the world. Back to you. What kind of advice can you give to parents and most especially young girls that are growing up?
Basically, as a successful businesswoman like me,
mm.
The kind of life I suffered,
mm.
and go through,
mm.
I did not advise parents to allow their children to go for street hawking, because there is a lot of challenges.
Mm.
And I write a book about it, you can find it.
Okay.
I give a lot of I give a lot of advice on it,
mm.
for people to see.
Thank you so much. And Hajia Fadila, what do you think are solutions?
The advice I will give,
mm.
I will emphasize on parents.
Okay.
Because no child will like going up and down,
mm.
hugging. Because our children of nowadays have a very smart brain, more than the olden days. They don't know what is harmful for us who grew up,
mm.
in the olden days,
mm.
life or whatsoever it is.
Mm.
We don't know what is good and bad. But for now, these children, they know the moral, they can differentiate the moral and immoral.
Mm.
They have the smartness due to generation is changing.
Mm.
So what I will advise parents is let them stop sending their children to hawk. Parents should bear patience and create some little business that will be done inside home, indoors, without going out, because they are exposing their children to danger.
Thank you so much, Honorable Commissioner, for this important point, and also Hajia Fadila Mustafa.
You're welcome.
And a former hawker and also a successful businesswoman.
Yes, thank you.
I really enjoyed these conversations, and I remain your favorite and also regular host, Aisha Kirawa.
Then we have the second Vox Pop.
What is your name, please?
My name is Adam Abdullahi.
From what department?
Department of Mathematics and Computer Science.
Okay, what if you are caught during the examination exchanging booklet with your girlfriend? What would be your reaction?
Exchanging booklet?
Yes, with your girlfriend.
And we have been caught?
Yes.
It depends on the reaction of the invigilator, that's the person that caught us. And it depends on the action they are going to take. So if the action is going to be for me to sign the malpractice form, I will not agree, because maybe she's the one that is copying from me. But if I'm the one copying, I will be the one to take this thing. But if she's the one copying, my sister, she will be the one to sign the malpractice form, because I cannot come and carry another person load on my head. Yes.
Thank you. Hello, what's your name?
My name is Rukaiya.
In which department?
Chemistry department.
Okay. So as you're writing your final exams and you suddenly get cuffed exchanging booklets with your boyfriend and the vigilator offered to help one of you, will you sacrifice?
I'm not sacrificing.
Why?
Just because if he was in my place, he's not going to sacrifice. Nobody is going to sacrifice for anybody.
Okay, so you have to face the consequences.
Yes.
Thank you. What is your name, please?
My name is Paul Zakaria.
Okay, from which department?
Statistics department.
Okay, what if you are caught in an examination hall exchanging booklet with your girlfriend? What would be your reaction?
In the first place, I would feel so bad because I was caught together with my girlfriend. Though I was exchanging with her, trying to help her, I believe, right?
Yes.
I'm the one trying to help her, right?
Yes.
So that would be a very tough moment for me. But I think if they are to punish one person among us, I would choose me to be punished, myself to be punished. Yeah.
Welcome to the official Niger Top 3 musical video. On today's episode, we have the latest, the best, and the hottest song in the country. And I'm your presenter, Mazi. And with me here in the studio today, we have our guest, in person of Nasty Black. Nasty Black. Nice to meet you.
Thank you so much, Mazi.
Nasty Black, we'd like to know more about you before we go on the section.
Yeah, my name is Nasty Black. I've been in the industry for like 2 years now. I have high inspiration from a legend called Davido. So like, I really appreciate the invitation. I appreciate that. Thank you so much, Mazi.
Thank you. Thanks for coming us again. So on today's top three, we are going to start with Loki by Mayokun. Mayokun is a singer, songwriter, and a professional musician. With this, Loki is one of the best songs in the country. Here is the video.
Dandy Mande, Baba Dandy Mande, Pere Bobo Mijakpa Satu Male, Oja Mimae, Demi Landi Cafe, Wato Ale.
You better focus on your fitness, even if it take me time to reach your peak. Push out my neighbor when I did that. Guinea latest, killing the world, making money plus interest. Plenty explanation, no evidence. Paper the media can invest. Loki. I've been steady taking shit from people that don't deserve it. Your mobile. Boy, I take my self food, I love. Come on, look, why maybe I know. Yeah, we know you go be a con. Loki. I've been steady jumping with people, we ready to jump in. No more para. Boy, I take my self food, I love. Come on, look, why maybe I know. Yeah, we know you go be a con. If you too sweet, then go lick you finish. If you want peace, then go break in pieces. The matter pass my hand. Got all my bad out. Kilo dirty moving bad out. Many more plenty jar out. No disprints now, marathon gone. Make a guy be you go.
So, tell me, how do you see this Mayokun of the board?
Yeah, Mayokun have been in the industry and he has been of great impact to the music industry. Where he came with a left foot of his first music, or first hit music, I've been a band from there. And till date, he has been keeping it hot and steady. So Mayokun is a yes for me. Yeah, I love his music.
Alright, so now we are moving on to number 2.
At number two, we have Reason by Omale. And now this song is very special because with the way things are going in this country, definitely you must have that song on your phone.
How long will it take you to realize? I don't know who to run to right now. I'm is open in every fire. I'm a safe bouncy out there. What are we doing, my dear, my dear? I surrender you myself, myself. My hands are in the air. What is the reason you do not have your peace of mind? Are you having fun or are you doing this thing to survive? Are you taking the pictures of every memories of your life? What's the reason why we're still out here? Jiggly can give me one better thing or two. Make a nigga suit and tie, let him fly like you. You the root, you try untie my shoes. Is that you? What are we doing, my dear, my dear? I surrender you myself, myself. My hands are in the air, the air. Only time will tell the difference, clear. What is the reason you do not have your
what do you see about this song, that Reason? Like, what prompted him to make that song? Like, why?
Yeah, Reason by Omale. That song comes with a lot of inspiration because it got like, it's just like a question actually. When they say, what is the reason that you, yeah, something like that. So it comes with a lot of question actually. Yeah, it's a yes for me also. It's a yes for me. Okay. I love Omale, yeah.
Alright, I'm not asking that song, what's the reason, like the lyrics? What's the reason you don't have any peace of mind? What are you doing? Are you doing it for fun? You're just doing it to survive.
There are some people that like, it's just directing the question to some people who don't know what they are doing actually. Yeah, because I met Omale at first time, we met at Port Harcourt, so that was like, he's a very nice and calm guy actually, calm and steady. So that music is like straight to people that doesn't know what they are doing. So what is the reason you're doing this? It's just kind of a question. Yeah,
right.
So it's a yes one.
Now we're going on to the final and last. The number one, Feel by Davido. Now, Davido is a legend, a big time legend in the music industry. And this video has been nominated for the Grammy. I pray and I hope it gets the Grammy Award.
I'll be on the phone, calling you tonight. I wanna make you show me, make me know the fight. I don't wanna sleep alone, wanna hold you tight. I fool my eyes, but I'll be alright. Forever. On my laptop. On my keto. BDBD. On my cheat on. Say them go feel it. Them go run it down. Them go hold it. Them go. Say them go feel it. Them go run it down. To myself, and I don't even notice. She got me feeling like a zombie, and she did shoot like Chuck Norris. The way she put her body down, you got me falling truly. I just touched down, when I see you now. So I've been on the phone, calling you tonight. I wanna make you show me, make me know the fight. I don't want sleep alone.
Davido have been like this, like it's one of his biggest music in his album, Timeless, right?
Yes.
Yeah, it's one of his biggest music. Like Like my dream as an artist now is like to meet Davido. Because I need promotion, oh bro. Baba, I beg, see me, oh, I beg. Anyway, see me, I beg, help me, I beg. Like, it's a hit, like, to be nominated for the Grammy Award. It's like, it's a global recognition actually for me. So it's a big 100% yes to me. Yeah, to feel is, yeah, like, I love it, I love it. Davido, I beg, I beg, I beg. Mas, I beg. They help me call it.
Alright, and so yeah guys, we would like to know which of them makes the number one for you. Is it Loki by Mayokun or Reason by Omale or Feel by Davido? So guys, we have come to the conclusion of today's episode on the Nigeria Top 3. And I want you to tell me which one you feel should be the number one. Is it Mayokun, Loki, or Omale, Reason, or you feel like the Davido, that particular feel, should be number one? You can reach us at on Twitter, on Facebook, and on Instagram at Ninja Top 3 Music Video. For now, we leave you, we love you, and peace. See you guys in the next episode.
See you guys.
Nasty Black, thanks again for coming.
Thanks so much, thanks so much. Enjoy.
And finally, we have the special report.
Kiar Mifak, widely known as Zoo, was established in 1970 as Neem Tree Plantation, which was later changed to Yakubu Gowon Recreational Center. In 1975, the Yakubu Gowon Recreational Center was also renamed to Shehu Sandakiar Mifak. After the Shehu of Borno, Shehu Sandakiar Mifak donated his farmland for the establishment of Zoological Center. The then president of Kenya, Mr. Lemo Kenyatta, along with some other individuals and groups, donated some wild animals to Zoological Garden. The acting general manager, Shehu Sandakiar Mifak, Mrs. Fatima Fayos Brima, said the essence of this park is to, according to her, the zoological park provides an avenue to students to learn about those wildlife animals and plantation. The zoological park is also a recreational center where people visit on a regular basis, especially during festive seasons, often paying entrance fee to see wild animals and enjoy the atmosphere. Mohammed Aisami reported.
He was. With this, we wrap up our edition of this program. Stay tuned and enjoy upcoming program that is brought to you from the service of Bosu TV. I am Ahmed Medugu, saying goodbye for now.